Hello dear students, I am Pratima. I welcome you all to this video, another case study questions based from probability, which may come in as your 5 marks in CBSE board examination. So let us read the questions very carefully. The probability distribution function quiz shows the number of hours of X, a student studying during the lockdown period in a day, is given by X is equal to 0, 1, 2. X is value 1, 0, 1, 2, 2. And Px is equal to your 3c cube, 4c minus 10c square, and 5c minus 1. On the where c is greater than 0, on the basis of this above information, answer the following question. The correct answer for c is 3c cube minus 10c square plus c minus 20. 3c cube plus 10c square plus c minus 20. 3c cube minus 10c square plus 10c is equal to 0. None of this. Part 2 is the value of c is equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 6. Probability of x less than 2 is equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 6. Fourth part is x greater equal to 1, 2 by 9, 1 by 9, 2 by 3, 1 by 3. X is greater than equal to 0, 0 up 1 by 3, 1. So as I told earlier, each part has a relation with the next part. That's why every part should be correct. For first one, what concept will apply? We know that summation of probability of all random variable, it is always 1. So whatever is given in the block, 3c cubed plus 4c minus 10c square plus 5c minus 1 is equal to 1. The simplify, 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 1 minus 1. How much it will be? Minus 2. So the equation is 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 2 is 0. Where is the answer? The answer is your c. So first part is completed. Coming to second part, the value of c, the value of c, that means from this equation you have to find the value of c. 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 2 is 0. This is a cubic polynomial. So how to find it? You will apply the factor theorem. For factor theorem, first, I'm going for c is equal to 1. If I'll get 0, then c minus 1 is a factor, or c is equal to 1, then I'll get other two factors because it will have three values of c. Now to test, I'm taking a very short method. What is it? I'm taking the sum of all the coefficients. First is your 3, next is minus 10, next is plus 9, next is minus 2. If this sum gives you 0, then c is 1. You can remember for your future any reference. So see, you can test it, you will get a 0. So c is equal to 1 means c is 1 as a solution, we got it. Next, how to get other two? I'll divide this 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 2, dividing by c minus 1. I'll get the other factor. What I'll get? Let me check. 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 2. Very quickly you will do c minus 1, then it will be c minus 1. 3c square. We are getting 3c cube minus 3c square. Then you will get minus 7c square plus 9c. Next I'll go for minus 7c. Minus 7c square plus 7c, then 2c minus 2. Here I'm getting 2. So other factor is 3c square minus 7c plus 2. You split the middle term. 3c square minus 6c minus c plus 2 is equal to 0. 3c taking common, you'll get c minus 2. Minus 1 taking common, you'll get c minus 2. So you're getting c minus 2 into 3c minus 1 is 0. So what I'm getting c is equal to 2 What I'm getting? I'm getting 3c is equal to 1 or c is equal to 1 by 3. So now let us check what is given. C value of c is 1 by 2. It is not there. 1 by 3. Yes, it is there. 1 by 3. And you know that c is equal to 2 cannot be the answer because here the probability cannot, it will be more than 1. So c is equal to 1 by 3. When we are getting the answer, so click it, that will be 1 by 3. We'll write the answer, c is equal to 1 by 3. Now after getting c is equal to 1 by 3, other part are easy because all the values of the next parts depend on the value of c. If you see, x less than 2, x greater than 2, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, all depends on the c. So c must be correct. Next part. So we have got c is equal to 1 by 3. C is equal to 1 by 3. Now I'll go for third part. X is less than 2. When x is less than 2, that means it is probability of x is equal to 0 plus probability of x is equal to 1. What is probability of x is equal to 0? X is equal to 0 is 3c cube. So this will be 3 into c is 1 by 3 whole cube. So you are getting 3 into 1 by 27. That will be your 1 by 9. And px is equal to 1. Px is equal to 1, you will get how much? It is your px equal to 1 this much. 4c minus 10c square. 4 into 1 by 3 minus 10 into 1 by 3 square, 1 by 9. So 4 by 3 minus your 10 by 9. It will simply. So these are the p is equal to x equal to 0, p is equal to x equal to 1. So p, x less than 2, I'll write 1 by 9 plus 4 by 3 minus 10 by 9. If we take like terms first, you are getting 4 by 3 minus 9 by 9, that is 1. You're getting 1 by 3. So where is the answer? 1 by 3. B is the answer. B is the answer. Now coming to fourth part. Fourth part is px is equal to 1. X is equal to 1, we have already calculated. Where is it? This one. X is equal to 1. So 4 by 3 minus 10 by 9. So what is LCM? LCM is 9. It will be 12 minus 10. 2 by 9. Where is 2 by 9? 2 by 9 is here. So if you are able to do all the questions, four parts, you need a going for fifth part. But you should learn, it may ask, be asked in another question. Px greater than equal to 0. This is the simplest one. Greater than equal to 0 means it will start from 0 to all the terms. What is it? It is always 1. So no need of calculation. This is t. So we got the answer. First is c, 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 2 is 0. How we got? We got probability of all summation is equal to 1. We make it. Second is we use the factor theorem to get 1 by 3, c is equal to 1 by 3. We got three values. One is c is equal to 1, c is equal to 2, c is equal to 1 by 3. But our answer B is matching with this, so B is this one. X is less than 2. X less than 2 means X equal to 0, equal to 1. You can write together, you can find the sum. It will be 2 by 9. Next is 1 by 3. Next is PX exactly equal to 1. So this is the answer. You'll put the value of C. And when X is greater than or equal to 0, it is always equal to 1. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, so that you can get the scope to learn more. Thank you.